Hello, it's Tom from Texas, and it's time for another Floppy Deep Dive. Today I'm going to go over a common question people ask when they get their Commodore 64 out of storage or they buy one from eBay in 2021. How do I hook up my Commodore 64 to a monitor? Today I'm going to show you how to hook up a 5-pin or 8-pin Commodore 64 to a VGA monitor at an affordable price. If you like this video or if it helps you, let me know. Please subscribe. Let's get started. So you got your Commodore 64 out of storage, wherever you had it, or you purchased it on eBay, or you picked it up somewhere, and you're trying to figure out the best way to connect it to the TV. I was recently in that position when I got my Commodore out of the attic back in August, and I had to figure out how I can hook this up. Back in the day, we were hooking up the Commodore to the TV with this device here, where we could switch from the TV to the computer and back and forth. But unless you have one of these older style TVs, you can no longer use this. So this isn't usable any longer. So I am going to show you how to hook up your Commodore 64 to something you probably have in your house still, which is a monitor for your computer using the VGA. Because the VGA is the most common working with monitors, and most people have multiple monitors. Well, I wouldn't say most, I don't know. But I had one VGA old monitor that I could use, so that's what I took to use to hook it up. So now I had to figure out which cable to use and what converter to use to be able to do that, and that's what I'm going to show you. So I got my two Commodores here. This is my original Commodore 64 from when I was a kid. And if you look at the back of this one, the pin on it is actually only a 5-pin. So it is different than my other Commodore 64, because my other Commodore 64 has an 8-pin video. Now the video is located right here, and this is how you can tell which kind of cable you're going to need to be able to hook up your Commodore 64. So definitely check out the video, both in the same spot. Check out the back of your Commodore 64 and make sure you're getting the right pin. This one again is the 5-pin, older model. This one I got in 1984. This is a newer bread bin, and it has the 8-pin. The 64Cs have the 8-pin. And it also, I've saw the 128s have the 8-pin. I haven't seen any of that at the 5. It's usually the older ones that have the 5-pin. So you just want to make sure that you're getting the right cable. So now that we've went over that, next I'm going to go over the different cables that you can get. Now, I get all of my cables from 8bitclassic.com. I just order them online. They range anywhere between $15 to $20, depending on shipping. Now this one's the 5-pin for this older one. With the 5-pin, you got your typical red and white audio, and you got your yellow composite. And when you have that, that's exactly what you need to be able to use with the converter I'm gonna be showing you here shortly. So the other cable that I have is the 8-pin. And with the 8-pin, again, I got all these cables off of 8bitclassics.com. No, they don't pay me to say that. I'm just showing you exactly how I did it because I needed to figure out how I could hook this up to a monitor. So with the 8-pin, you can get S-Video. So you get the same thing. You get your two audios, and then you also get your yellow composite. But then you also get an S-Video, which gives you a better quality of picture using the S-Video. Plus it leaves these other jacks free if you want to do something else with it, which I found very helpful. If I wanted to record what I'm showing on my screen, I could have an S-Video hooked up to one screen, and I could have my composite cables hooked up to another screen recording. So it actually came in very handy, and that might be another video another day. But today, that's the different cables. So I've got my 8-pin for right here for my Commodore 64 bread bin, and then for my older one, I got my 5-pin. So next, I'm gonna go over the converter. So this converter, I get off of Amazon, and the cost of this, again, is between $15 to $20, relatively cheap, not an expensive video converter. But the reason I use it is because it gives me exactly what I need. I've ordered three of these already. I've got my fourth one actually coming, but they have worked perfect for me. I've had zero issues with them, and it's just a video to VGA, and that's exactly what I want, because I have the VGA cable that I want to be able to hook up from the monitor, and I want to be able to hook in either with the S video right here, or with the yellow composite plug. And it has the option for VGA in, VGA out. That's not what I need. I need these two right here. So this way I could plug in the S video, I could plug in my VGA cable directly to my monitor, and it's can convert from my Commodore 64 through the S video to my monitor to give me exactly what I need. So these VGAs are really common, and so that's why I decided to go with them. And like I said, I have multiple of them around the house. Hopefully you do too. If you're into old computers or into computers at all, it's common to have a lot of monitors. I had a few, but I'll tell you what else I did to be able to get more monitors to hook up all my systems like I wanted to. So another, I told you, affordable way is I like the 4x3 monitors. They just look good with the Commodore 64. This here's a Dell monitor that I got at Goodwill. If you don't have a monitor or an extra monitor or one in your, you know, in your garage like I did, you can go to Goodwill like I did. I paid $13 for this monitor. A lot of people don't like the 4x3. That's old, so they're outdated. So they're relatively easy to get. So for $13, I got this nice monitor, and I'm going to hook this all up and show you exactly the hookup and the quality of picture that I get on this monitor right here. So I'm going to go back down. And let's look here again at the Commodores, and I'm going to hook this one up for you, showing you exactly how I do it in the picture. Do it. It is relatively simple and very easy to use. You do not have to be an expert at any of this at all. This is very simple. If you can plug in and match up colors, you've got it down. So I'm going to plug in on the side one. This is my VGA out. So this is going out to my monitor. I'm going to plug this into here, and then I'm going to take my 8-pin cable, and with my 8-pin cable, I'm going to take that, I'm going to set this off to the side for the minute, and I'm going to plug it directly into the video, right there. I'm going to move this one off to the side a little bit, just to give me some room. So again, this is the one that has all the different ones, the S video and the composite. I am going to use the S video here. So I'm going to plug the S video in. And then I'm going to have to give this some power. So the power cord that comes with it is very short, doesn't have a very long cable. That's the one downfall of this little converter. But for how cheap it is, I won't complain. And I've always seemed to find to be able to make it work. So I'm going to go ahead and plug this in now and let you see what the monitor looks like. All right, let's move this one out of the way. Yes, I'm using the new brick by Kevin Autumn, I think his name is. I've got three of his new bricks, and I love them. They work perfect. Another video, so I'm not using the original one. I'm using the new one, so nobody freak out and tell me, make sure I'm using the right one. If you're hooking up your Commodore 64, even though this is not a video on power supplies, everyone will warn you that the old power supplies are crap and they eventually will kill your computer. It's not a lie. They're telling you the truth, just not what this video is about. All right, so let's power this one up. Just like that. There's the quality of the picture of it with the S video, which I think looks really good. I don't have any drives or anything hooked up on here, but as you can see, quality of it is very clear. And it actually worked just perfect. So here I am with a $13 monitor that I got at Goodwill. And I'm going to say it was not just luck that I got this at Goodwill. they had a lot of monitors there. People, like I said, swapped out monitors many, many times to get, you know, the latest and greatest gaming monitors. And these older ones are just very easy and very inexpensive right now to get. You know, obviously every Goodwill varies, but I say check yours and see our thrift store or wherever you go to get that kind of stuff. But mine, I had no issues. I actually picked up two. This is just one of them. I got this one for, like I said, $13, and I got my other one for $9. And again, I went with the 4x3 screen just because I like how that looks on the Commodore 64. But it really is just that easy with that converter, the correct cable, and with this monitor, I got it hooked up and ready to go at a very affordable price, and it's ready to roll, and it looks good. So now I've hooked in my 5-pin, and this is my old Commodore, and I'm just using the composite cable. As you can see, I just have my composite cable plugged in. Again, the power cord is not very long to get to it. But so I just have that one plugged in directly. And then you can also see on the monitor a little bit more noise and so forth. Not as good a call quality because it is composite, but it does work perfectly for it. So that's all the difference is instead of using the S video, I'm using the composite cable here. I hope this video helped you. I have included links to Amazon for the converter and to 8-bit Classic for the cables in the description below. Please subscribe to my channel, and I hope you enjoyed another Floppy Deep Dive.